I recently made those particle alerts and y'all seem to love them. So I decided to remake them, but taking a different approach. See, the original ones were 2D, made in Adobe After Effects with their particle system. But this time I wanted more particles. I wanted them to take more space on the screen, but I also wanted them to be 3D. So check out the link in the description. Just like the previous ones, those are going to be completely free. And one of the reasons why I can afford to make them free is thanks to today's sponsor. And this video is sponsored by CutLabs.ai. CutLabs is a service that uses AI to basically perform the task of going back and watching your VODs to clip stuff so that you can post on social media. It's compatible with both Twitch and YouTube. It basically monitors your channel so that every time you're done with a stream, it goes back and clips a bunch of stuff from your VOD. It'll create those short form vertical clips to help you promote your channel. And it's really good at detecting events that happen in those specific games. So if you're popping off in game, being funny, hyped, everything, it'll know and it'll clip it. That being said, I personally tried it with games that are not in that list and it works pretty well. You can actually search by term. If you type, oh my God, it'll find every moment that you said that during the stream. Oh, and also every time you say clip that, now you will actually have a clip. So basically after you're done streaming now, you can grab a snack, relax, and when you're ready to post, you'll have a bunch of clips waiting for you. If you want to edit them, reframe them, maybe change the caption style, you can do all that, then just download. CutLabs is free to use, but if you want more options, you can check out their premium plan, which you can test in a 14-day trial. So right now, there's no excuse for you not to pump out clips on the regular and potentially go viral. So go try it out at cutlabs.ai or just click on the link in my description. So the software I'm using here is Blender 3D. No, I will not be making Blender tutorials, but I basically set up a particle system that would create kind of this ball of particles. All I had to do is set a camera looking straight down and the result would be like this, or actually more like this. So just like the last time, we have the hearts to signify follows. I also modeled this bit thing for cheers. I had this crown that I modeled a while ago, but I really don't like it. And also that would be probably for like top tipper or top cheerer. So this is not included. What we do have is a star, just like that. And basically I can change the particle emitter. Anyways, we can test the results by checking out those WebM files. Those are the files that you're going to get. I also went with a square this time, which means you'll get more versatility when it comes to how to place them in OBS Studio, which I'm gonna show you in a little bit. And of course the hearts, there you go. You can always add those as media sources to OBS and trigger them through a bot, or you can just put them in whatever alert service you're using. In this case, Stream Elements. I can go to overlays, create a new overlay, and basically set up a new alert box. This time I'm gonna go custom because those alerts are custom. It's actually 1920 by 1920. Click start, click add widget. We want alert box. I'm immediately gonna go to position and size. I'm gonna set this to 1920 by 1920. Okay, now go back to settings and we're gonna turn off everything that we don't need. So we don't have any tip alert here. We do not have any rate alerts or purchase alerts. We only have follower, subscriber, and cheer. So follower alert, click on the cogwheel. I'm gonna click on the X here to clear this and I'm going to change video. I'm gonna click on upload, top right. And from there, I can drag and drop my files. So I have this one, that one, drag, drop. Okay, so this one is the heart. I'm gonna click submit. And I'm gonna make sure that I clear the sound also. So no sound with this, mostly because I'm gonna combine it with other alerts. I also want the layout to be text over image. And I also want no text here at all. I forgot to explain that those alerts are meant to be behind your webcam during your gameplay scene. So when your webcam is in a corner somewhere, this alert would be behind it to give it more energy. So this is the only scene where those will be visible. This is why we're clearing it out. Something else that we need to make sure we clear out is variations. So right now there's no variations on follows, so that's a good thing, which means that we can move on to subscriber. Okay, clear the sound, change video, select the star animation, submit, text over image, no text here, and variation settings. We actually have a couple of ones. So what we're gonna do is turn them off and close this. And finally, we have cheer, same thing, clear, text over image, delete the text, change video, submit the right animation, go to variation settings and clear those out. Okay, so top left here, I'm gonna actually name it 3D protocols. Top right here, I'm going to click save. Then we're gonna click on the link icon. You see copy overlay URL, click that. So now in OBS Studio, we can go to our gameplay scene. I have this fake gameplay going on right now, and we can add a browser source. So source browser 3D particles. And we can paste that link that we just copied from Stream Elements. Now remember the size was 1920 by 1920, which is obviously going to be bigger than your frame itself, but click OK. And you can see how big it is. It's mostly on the height. And I'm preemptively gonna add it kind of towards the middle. A good way to eyeball it is to put that top handle here in the middle of my webcam and then just drag it straight up and then use that handle on the right to figure out the middle. There you go. Then of course we want to put the source itself behind our webcam. You can see I have cam overlay here. Just bloop. Then in order to test it, we're gonna go back to Stream Elements and we're gonna click emulate follower event. And that's what it's gonna look like. Let's try it again. So I have a whole bunch of them now. Let's try a cheer event. And finally, let's try a subscriber event. All right, let's do the promo video. I created brand new particle alerts, but this time they're in 3D. This is what the follower event would look like. This is what cheers look like. And this is what subscribers look like. Make sure you watch the full video on YouTube to get them for free. Oh, quick thing. You can actually set those if you want them to be brighter, basically. You can actually set the blending mode to add. So let's do that. 3D particles, right click, go to blending mode and click add. And you'll see that now they'll blend a little bit better with the background. You see that? So it adds levels of transparency. Subscriber event would look like this. It's like that. And then cheer would be this. There you go. Of course, you can move it around. You can fill the screen as you please. Once again, link in the description. I don't know if I'm gonna put it on Gumroad. I should. I will. So check it out. Once again, link in the description and also in the top pinned comment. And let me know what you think.